Welcome to RTC TV. My name is Jared Michael, and today is December 3rd. We're watching Valley versus Marion at the McConaughey Wrestling Invite. Wrestling at 138 for the Vikings is Jordan Owens. That'll be a pin for Marion. Now, there was a bye earlier on in this invitational. Valley did have a bye the first round. Marion wrestled and won their first match. Here we have Chad E.V. Teeter wrestling at 145. Ref will call that. A headgear came off of Teeter. They both get ready to wrestle, and they're back wrestling, going at it. Marion going in for a simple single leg. Chevy fighting for his life not to get on his back and give Marion that takedown. Gives Marion the takedown, but saves himself from getting on his back. Seconds left to go. Teeter looking for a reversal, just trying to defend off those halves right now. Looking for that roll. Typically, Valley doesn't like a rolling type scheme in folk style wrestling. Teeter tends to like to go with the rolls. They're very high risk, but high reward as well. Thank you. Beginning of the second period, Teeter down 2-0. Teeter trying to get to his base. Can't really defend himself being on his belly. That makes it hard to maneuver, and you just have no strength from that position. Trying to defend those halves. The ref will warn stalling of against Valley. Teeter being very close to reversal. 1 second left to go. And that'll be the end of the second period. Third period, Teeter getting a little pep talk from Coach Kyler Kirby, second year coaching for the Vikings. And this is the first time the Vikings have ever been to the McConaughey invite, so hopefully it'll be a good first time for them. Marion does appear to be cut, being doctored up over there on the side. Can't have blood on the mat. That wouldn't be good at all. Cleaning up the mat as well. And the wrestling will resume as soon as they get all that blood cleaned up. Third period, Marion chooses down. Teeter on top, score still 2-0. Team score 6-0, Marion in the lead. Marion escapes, getting a point. And still no change. Marion setting back to the inside of the mat. Doesn't want to be caught on the outside, get a takedown, and have that taken away from them because they're out of bounds. 1 minute left to go in this match. Score is 3-0. Teeter really needs a takedown and some back points here in order to get the win. Teeter with the takedown. Marion going on the defense. 40 seconds left to go for Teeter to score 2 points to win. Marion is in the lead. Let's Marion up. Takedown will tie it. Score now 2-4. 30 seconds left to go in the match. Marion goes in for the takedown and will get the takedown on Valley. Two-point near fall is awarded as well to Marion. They're just going to call that match. Score. 8 seconds. The clock did not stop. They're putting 8 seconds back up on the clock. They reset to the center. Marion looking for a very, very fast pin here. Chevy as well. He's gonna stay off away from Chevy, giving himself more time, just wasting clock here. And that'll be the match. Marion clinches the win. Team score currently 9-0, Marion in the lead. Here we have wrestling at 52, Jonathan Humes for the Vikings. This is his first varsity match, taken down quickly by Marion. You know, he's fighting very well for his first match. Blood time will be enacted. Looks like a bloody nose, probably caught in the takedown. Valley's coach is not wasting the time to talk to the wrestler, John Humes. Ref scouring the mat, looking for any other blood. Wrestling will resume. 1:37 left to go in the first period. Marion with the leg up, slamming down Humes. Humes getting up very fast for a beginning wrestler. His back is to the mat though, dangerous position. Marion has that half Nelson in and is just going to cinch it tighter. 1:03 left to go in the first. Things do appear grim for Humes. Humes fighting continually back to his base and up. near fall will be awarded. To Marion, an escape will be awarded to the Vikings, and blood time enacted again. This time both wrestlers do have blood on their body, so it has to be cleaned up. Nose is are an awfully hard thing to fix with blood time. Really hard to stop that blood, and if it gets hit again, it just wants to seem to bleed more. And it would appear both wrestlers are getting ready. Matt still being cleaned up. Long first period because of this blood. Given Humes a bit of a rest, considering this is his first varsity match, so he's got to be taking that and thinking that. Seconds left to go in the first period. Humes being the aggressive factor, something we haven't seen so far. Marion catching him, saving himself. And that'll be a nice double leg by Marion. Marion looking to cinch in a cradle. He has it. Having a hard time rolling Humes over. 5 seconds left to go. Looks like that'll be the end of the first period. Right now, match score is 9 Marion, 1 Valley. It's Valley's choice. Valley will choose top. Marion quickly escaping. Him started to go in tight there, realized he didn't exactly want to do that and backed out pretty quickly. Looks like Humes is in a great position to score right now. And they're just going to call that neutral as they go out of bounds. Marion going in for the takedown. Humes using that momentum and continuing that roll. Looking for a cow catcher, Marion expecting it. Gets the takedown, and Humes is in another bad position. 1:02 left to go in this second period. And that'll be a pin. Wrestling at 160 for the Vikings is Isaac Randall. Yeah. Randall going in for a quick single leg. Gets it. That's 2 points. Randall is a junior and team captain for the Vikings. I've watched him mature over the years, and it's great to see him being an aggressive wrestler this year. And I'll call that out of bounds. Randall trying to work in a power half. Marion doing a great job trying to get back up to his base. He's got a wrist and a half, and he's tilting him over. This will be the first time the Vikings have been in control. Getting in the pin. That'll be the Vikings' first score against Marion. Right now, current team score 18-6. And here we have wrestling at 170 pounds, Tyler Manuzak, senior. A senior, not there's a younger Tyler Manuzak. Captain for the Vikings. This is his second year wrestling. Going against a Marion opponent who's willing to do a muscle match along with Manuzak. Gets the takedown. And the pin, Manuzak does have a problem with trying to go for a throw early on in the match, which leads to a very bad positions lots of times. Wrestling at 182 for the Vikings is Joseph Irons, freshman. This is his first year wrestling for varsity. Tying up with the Marion opponent. Irons and Marion scrambling. Irons awarded the takedown and has Marion on his back. This is the first time Irons has ever been in this position. Seconds left to go. Marion struggling to get to his belly, and that'll be the pin. Irons' first high school win. Valley does not have a wrestler higher than Joseph Irons' weight class, so we will have to forfeit the 195-pound weight class, the 220-pound weight class, and the 285-pound weight class.
Okay.
Wrestling at 106 for the Vikings is sophomore Haley Hoover. Would appear Marion also has a female wrestler. This is Haley's second high school match. First ever tournament showing. Hand fighting happening. Hair piece of Marion falling off. You got to get that hair tucked in. It could give an uneven advantage to Haley. They'll count that as their injury time as they try to fix that. They are trying to fix that hairpiece for the Marion wrestler. Ref supervising, making sure it's going on good, so that way it hopefully won't fall off again. Hoover staying warm on her side, listening to the coaches as they're prep talking her to prepare for the match. Match will resume. Both wrestlers still in the neutral position. 1:35 left to go in the first. Neither wrestler taking shots, just simply reaching for the legs. Thank you. 10 seconds left to go in the first period. And that'll be the end of the first period. Second period, Marion's choice. They will defer. Vikings are given the choice. They choose neutral. It would appear Coach Kirby thought that she had a good chance to score a few times. Both wrestlers getting ready. Marion appears very tired. And Haley will get the takedown. Marion getting a reversal. Works the half in. Haley working back up to the base, trying to get a switch, and gets the reversal. Haley now working with the half, and gets the pin. Vikings do not have a 113 wrestler at the moment. He will be joining after this first round for the Vikings. He missed a couple days of practice, and the coaches decided to sit him out for this first match. £120 for the Vikings. We have Devin Bandow, the junior. Looks like Bandow's gonna be taking the forfeit at 120 and instead wrestling at 126 pounds. Devin was the only one that had a win against Peru on Wednesday. Current team score 18-54, Marion in the lead. Thank you. headgear falling off of the Marion. Rustler again. Bandow getting lucky with that takedown, giving his back up, able to recover quickly. Has the 2 points. The ref will call them out of bounds there. Bandow keeping him in that position. Gets a pin for the Vikings. That'll be Valley's last wrestler as they have to forfeit the 132-pound weight class. Final team score will be 24-60. Marion with the lead. Key wrestler for the Vikings in that match would be Devin Bandow with that very successful pin there early on. We'll be heading to the third round here soon enough as the Vikings take a quick break after that loss. And we'll see you then. Welcome back to the Mconaqua Invite. Handshaking of the captains was just done. This is the third round, second round of wrestling for the Vikings as they will face off against the Whitco Wildcats. This match will start off at 145 pounds. Wrestling for the Vikings is Chevy Teeter. For the Wildcats, that would be R.J. Patrick, both sophomores. Checking in at the table. Some quick last second weight changes as they're moving wrestlers around, trying to decide where they want them to wrestle. Now they're bringing over the mat managers. coaches discussing on the mat. Still discussing with the ref. Again, the Vikings did have a bye for the first round of this invitational. And they'll give a forfeit to Chevy Teeter at 145. Wrestling at 152 pounds for the Vikings is Jonathan Humes. His second varsity match. Hand fighting. Trying to go for a throw. Woodco getting the takedown. I'm sorry, they will award that to Valley. With a half synced in, he's going to try to tighten that down to get his first time having an opponent on his back. Cinched in tight, 1 minute left to go in the first period. Witko will manage to roll over. Humes keeping him down and is awarded the 3-point near fall. And that'll be Hume's first varsity win. Wrestling at 160 pounds for the Vikings will be Isaac Randall. And it looks like they'll give him a forfeit. Wrestling at 170 pounds for the Vikings is freshman Joseph Irons. Irons being the aggressive figure in this match, had a headgear problem early on. That's been struggling him, or he's been something he's been struggling with the entire high school career. Whitkill looking for that throw. Irons able to keep his head back and get the takedown. Joseph Irons has a grapevine locked in. And that'll be Irons' second pin. Manny Zach wrestling at 182 for the Vikings. Struggling so far this season with being too aggressive and not thinking while wrestling. Wildcat opponent being thoughtful and methodical in his wrestling approach. Manizak goes in for a quick shot. And finishes the shot with a half in. They'll call that a full Nelson and give Whitco 1 point. Whitco being fast off the whistle. And gets the reversal. Able to roll back around and get the reversal again. Manizak struggling to run that half. Locks in a cradle and gets his hips over top, giving him in a bad position. His shoulders are inside the ring, so a pin will be possible. Bridging up and rolling through, something that I've seen Valley doing a lot better this season over previous years. And that'll be the end of the first period. Valley's choice after Whitco defers. Valley will choose neutral. Whitco being the aggressive factor right off the whistle. Something we haven't seen from him so far this match. Headgear coming off. No reset. Coach is signaling that they're looking for an arm drag from him. Let's see if he's able to do that. Pulls in Manizak for a double leg takedown. Match score currently 10 Whitco, 4 Valley. Manizak struggling to stand up. Whitco running a Butcher on Manny Zach. Manny Zach getting the escape. Manny Zach giving up the takedown and the pin. 20 seconds left to go in the second period. Whitco will get their first team points of the match. Current team score 24-6. Vikings will have to forfeit 195 pounds. As well as 220 pounds. Neither team has a heavyweight. Wickhill off to 4'106" to Haley Hoover. And they will also have to forfeit 113 to Jacob Ehrman. Wrestling at 120 pounds for the Vikings is junior Devin Bandow. So far being a key wrestler for the Vikings. His first year high school wrestling, I've been very surprised with the ferocity that he comes out with his matches. Bandow staying fast. Facing opponent that seems to wrestle in roughly the same style he does. Able to catch the cow catcher in. Driving through, getting the takedown. Valley wrestlers chanting for the pin. Three-point near fall awarded to Bandow. One-point escape to Whitco. Current match score 5-1. Fifty-two seconds left to go in the first period. Whitco taking a shot as Bandow is resetting. Taking advantage of that. Bandow fighting to get his legs back. Able to get the takedown after circling behind. Trying to work in a half while still in the upward position is oftentimes difficult to do and can give your position quite the advantage, as in right there. They won't give Whitco the escape as the time expired before he was done. Whitco's choice. Whitco will defer. Vikings will choose neutral. Bandel definitely being very successful in the neutral position last period. Whitco again shooting first. Getting a shot, Bandel sprawling. Trying to throw in a cradle from standing position. No takedown awarded. Neither wrestler had control there. Both wrestlers fighting for any advantage they can get. And they're going to call that out of bounds. Match resumes, 40 seconds left to go in the second period. Bandel is winning 7-1. And we'll get the takedown. Whitco getting a reversal. And a 2-point near fall. And that'll be the end of the second period. Currently, match score is 9 Vikings, 5 Whitco. Team score, 36 to the Vikings, 18 to the Wildcats. Whitco will choose the offensive position or top. Valley in the defensive position. Looking for a score here. Whitco awarded 2-point near fall as both wrestlers roll out of bounds. Bandel will still be down. Right now, score is 9-7. Bandel still in the lead. Trying to get up quickly, working those hands. Whitco appears ready for this third period. Bandel struggling right now. Whitco working in that butcher. Bandel struggling to stay off his back. Pushing into the opponent, pushes his own back on the mat, and Whitco will get the pin. Wrestling at 126. Vikings will have to take a forfeit. If Witko has a wrestler. Vikings will take that forfeit. At 132 pounds. Neither team has a wrestler, so that'll be a double forfeit. But at 138 pounds, Jordan Owens will take the forfeit for the Vikings. That'll be the Vikings' first team win of the night and second team win overall. Final score, 42-30, Vikings over Witko. Welcome as they finish up the third round of the Manchester Invite. Again, I'm Jared Michael.
We're about ready to start round
RTC
4.
I'm Jared
TV
Michael.
Channel 4.
With you on RTC TV Channel 4. Vikings will be facing North Miami in the fourth round. Vikings just coming off a win against the Witko Wildcats. We'll be starting off with the weight class of 152 pounds. For the Vikings, wrestling at 152 is Jonathan Humes, sophomore. Making sure the scoreboard is all ready to go. And the wrestlers are off. Jonathan Humes doing a good job so far in his first ever high school tourney with a quick pin against the Warriors right there. That'll give Valley the first team score, 6 points, and we'll move on to the 160-pound weight class. Wrestling for the Vikings is junior Isaac Randall. He'll take the forfeit. That'll be another 6 points for the Vikings. Discussion by the coaches as to the weight classes. Wrestling at 170 for the Vikings is freshman Joseph Irons. So far had 2 wins today. Circling, looks like they're gonna go in for a muscle match here. McConaughey reaching for that leg instead of going in for a shoot. He will shoot and Joseph Irons will get around. Keeping good hip pressure on North Miami, making it so that way he can't build up to his base. Trying to work in a half now. Valley's coach Kirby signaling that he needs to roll him over. And that'll be his third victory for the day. Right now, Irons is undefeated. And Tyler Manizak will take the forfeit. And Valley will have to forfeit anyone above the 182-pound weight class. At 106, Haley Hoover will wrestle. And it looks like she will take a forfeit. Never mind, she appears to have a wrestler. Starting off hesitant, North Miami does go in for that single leg. 2 points awarded to Warriors. Right now, currently, team score is 24-18. Hoover in a dire position. And that'll be the pin. And the team score is all tied up. At 120 pounds, or 113 pounds, wrestling for the Vikings is Jacob Ehrman, his first match of the day. North Miami's wrestler coming out fast and hard. That'll be out of bounds, back to neutral, as Ehrman did get the escape. Two points awarded to North Miami for a takedown. Ehrman gets the reversal. North Miami released hip pressure there, giving Ehrman the shot to get out and switch around like that. Ehrman working in a billy goat, keeping a hold of that leg with him to move the pile forward. Now he's grabbing his opponent's hand and bringing that in between his opponent's legs. It makes it really hard for the opponent to move, and it gives a lot more leverage to Ehrman. However, he lets go of that hand, and North Miami will get the reversal. Right now, match score is 3-6. North Miami in the lead. That'll be the end of the first period. Harriman working North Miami down. Harriman will get the escape after that reversal by North Miami. Another takedown by North Miami, and they'll be out of bounds there. North Miami will award Harriman with 1 point for the escape right off in order to get the neutral and the 2 point takedown right there. And that'll be the pin. Yeah, I think this is the last match before the lunch break. A lot of these wrestlers have to be getting tired here. At 120 pounds, wrestling for the Vikings is Devin Bandow Jr. So far doing great this season. And he'll get the takedown right away, running that leg in between the two legs, and gets the quick pin. 1:39 left to go in that first period. Looks like he was looking for a little retribution after that loss to Whitco after a long, hard battle. .126 pounds. The Vikings do not have a wrestler, so they will have to forfeit. Vikings also have to forfeit 132 pounds. At 138 pounds, the Vikings have Jordan Owens wrestling. Jordan flying out, trying a style I haven't seen in so far. North Miami goes in for the shot. And gets the takedown. Jordan Owens trying to lock up that cradle, not quite able to get it. Vikings really need a pin from Owens in order to have a chance to win this. 1 point escape. Tied up all now, 3-3. Again, Owens is Valley's last chance right here. If Owens loses this match without a pin, if Owens does not pin his kid right here, it could be over for the Vikings against North Miami. And that'll be a pin for Owens, giving Valley 36 points to 42, putting the tie on Chevy Teeter. If Chevy Teeter does not win this match by a pin, North Miami will win. It all comes down to this here. Teeter looking for a weakness in his opponent. Ref is going to call some sort of equipment malfunction. Do you believe it's blood time? Wrestlers getting doctored up. Teeter had a little bit of blood in his hairline. Both wrestlers attempting to look for shots. North Miami being successful in that scramble. As of yet, no points have been awarded. 2 points awarded for the takedown. Teeter setting himself up for the cradle. North Miami locks it in. And that'll be the pin. Final score, 36-48. Not sure why they marked up another 6 points to the Vikings. And they have it corrected. Both teams will shake hands. That was a great showing by the Vikings. They'll be seeing them later throughout the year. The Vikings appear ready for them. We'll head on into the lunch break now as the Vikings get ready for their fifth round. Again, I'm Jared Michael for RTC TV Channel 4. Hello and welcome back to the Tippecanoe Valley at Meconaquaw Invite as we're about ready to begin the fifth round of wrestling here. We're going to be starting off with the 160-pound weight class against Meconaquaw, the home team here. Wrestling at 160 pounds for the Vikings is Isaac Randall, Jr. Now, this is right after the lunch break, so this can make or break a team here as to how they show up right after this lunch break. Randall appears ready. His opponent appears to be taking their time, coming back from the lunch break. Tippecanoe Valley did have one of the longest lunch breaks. They finished their match very quickly, their match before the lunch break ended. So they had a very long lunch break period, giving them a lot of time to recover and recoup. Mekonikwa didn't have as long of a lunch break, therefore, you know, they're getting their time in. Ref showing that he's ready for the action to begin. Right now, currently, team-wise, Valley is 1-2. As they're going into their fourth round, they did have a bye that first round of wrestling. So other teams can look forward to a bye this round, and Valley has already gotten their bye through. Ref checking to make sure that headpiece is on good for Isaac's opponent, which is a girl. I think they're going to declare that headpiece unfit. And the new wrestler is signing in. Discussion on the mat. Isaac Randall there trying to stay warm. It would appear that they're swapping out the headpiece of that girl and getting her a new one so that way she can wrestle. Both wrestlers in the ring, finally. And they're gonna award 1 point to Valley for all the confusion. Randall getting a quick double leg. Working on that cross face. He's going to have to drag her in bounds if he's going to get the pin. Ref signaling that they're out of bounds. And Randall gets the pin. 1:21 left to go. Onto the 170-pound weight class. Looks like Valley will get a forfeit. That's freshman Joseph Irons. You know, so far he's undefeated. So it'll be his fourth victory for today. Tyler Manuzak wrestling at 182 for the Vikings. Senior. His second year wrestling. So far today, not doing the best job. He is 0-3 right now. He appears really aggressive, but he doesn't seem to be able to keep his wits about him as he's being aggressive. Getting that snap down. He's got that arm locked across for a front headlock. Looking to pull in the cradle here. And he'll get the two-point takedown. Manuzak working in on the wrist to drive that pile forward, making sure McConaughey cannot get back to his base. Now, if you'll notice, Tyler's right shoulder is taped up. That's because he has a torn labrum, and he was wearing a brace. However, he just felt like he didn't have the mobility with the brace, so he switched over to the taping. Tyler desperately trying to move his man forward. Tyler's straining to get that lift, and he does so. Yeah, remember, though, that moves like that are very tiresome and can drain you throughout the match. And that will be the end of the first period. McConaughey will choose down. Start of the second period. Team match score right now is 2-0. Team score 12-0. Vikings in the lead on both counts. Manuzak immediately breaking McConaughey down. Manuzak doing the best so far he's done all day. They're going to call that a stalemate. Manuzak quickly reacting to McConaughey. both wrestlers working right off the whistle. Manizak is trying to run that power half. He's a wrestler that favors a lot of moves that require a lot of strength. They're effective but tiring. And Manizak keeps control the entire second period. Third period, choice is his. Manizak will choose neutral. Third period. Takedown from McConaughey would mean tying it up. Tyler struggling with staying in ear to ear with his opponents all of today. Locking in that cradle. He's just got to roll it over now. Bad hip movement, gets the takedown. And there's the pin. McConaughey wrestler does not appear too happy with that. That'll be Tyler's first win of the day. Now, Valley does not have any wrestlers above the 182-pound weight class. So they'll have to forfeit 195, 220, and 285, tying up the score, team score, to 18-18 because of that, those forfeits there. At the 106-pound weight class for the Vikings is Haley Hoover, sophomore, her first year wrestling. McConaughey going in for a quick double leg trip. Gets it and gets the 2-point takedown. Working in a wing. He's going to stack Haley over, and there's the pin. McConaughey will gain the lead. 24-18 team score, McConaughey winning. At the 113 weight class, pound weight class for the Vikings, is Jacob Ehrman, freshman. And this ref here is definitely a fan of sportsmanship, shaking each wrestler's hand before each match. It's always good to see in a sport like this where they can be sportsmanlike before the match and after the match. Ehrman keeping a hold of that leg. And wins the scramble, 2 points awarded for the takedown. Yeah. Behrman's reaching that head over the body. Gives McConaughey great reach. And Ehrman in a bad position. All Ehrman needed to do, though, was throw in that half. Valley sideline stating that Ehrman needs to throw in the half. Good mat return by Ehrman. Ehrman working on the three-quarter Nelson. And the ref will signal him out of bounds. 5 seconds left to go in this first period. And that'll be the first period. Starting second period. Right now, match score is 2 for Vikings, 0 for McConaughey. Vikings choice. Vikings will choose top. Or the offensive position. McConaughey on the defensive position or down. Eckerman's inexperience as a freshman showing, constantly having the half there presented to him, and he's trying to do other moves. Once it's there, if you can just run that off of muscle memory, it makes life 1,000 times easier. But you'll learn that through experience and working through your high school career. So as a freshman, he's doing a pretty good job. Valley appearing to favor that power half in this match. And that's the end of the second period. Starting the third period, right now, current match score, 2 Vikings, 0 McConaughey. Ehrman gets a quick takedown. And they'll declare that an escape. Back to neutral they go. Current match score 4-1. Ehrman's sideline getting very excited as they're trying to get him to run that half. finally gets the half in. Struggling to execute it, though. They'll declare that another two-point near fall for Ehrman. Right now, Matt's score, 8-1. Ehrman struggling. Could be in bad position. The only way he can lose this match right now is from a pin. McConaughey has the headlock in. Ehrman needs to circle towards McConaughey. And that'll be a pin for the Braves. Hard-fought battle, and it's crazy how one mistake can lead to the match completely being over like that. 26 seconds left to go. Right now, current team score, 34 McConaughey, 18 for the Vikings. Wrestling at 120 pounds for the Vikings is Devin Bandow, Jr. Other matches have finished, so we got some spare refs. Wrestling at 126 is Devin Bandow. They bumped him up a weight class. Bandow being the aggressive factor, however, struggling to get any moves accomplished. Looking for an opening. Sprawl's good. That's a good save by Coach Smith. Bandow will get the takedown. Bandow working in the wing. Moves it over to an arm bar. They're going to call that out of bounds as they both reset to the center of the ring. McConaughey will be down. Bandow was in control. McConaughey getting a long sit. Oh. And they're going to call that a full Nelson on Bandow. 1 point awarded to McConaughey.
Yeah.
Bandow doing a move where he pinches his head in that shoulder to pull him backwards. Guess who's noticing McConaughey had a tendency to leave his chest up high. And that'll be the end of the first period before the pin is awarded. He gets a 3-point near fall. McConaughey will defer. Bandow will choose neutral. Doing a good job every time he's been up in the neutral. Circles around again. Leaves his head exposed. However, is able to recover. McConaughey gets the escape. That was a quick scramble. Again, I'm Jared Michael for RTC TV, Channel 4. McConaughey reaching back for that head. Often a mistake can lead to an easy half. Bandow, however, isn't capitalizing on that mistake. Less than a minute to go in the second period. Bandow rolls over that half. 47 seconds to be, and there's the pin. Be another 6 points awarded to the Vikings. Putting them at 24-36. McConaughey in the lead. As the Vikings will have to forfeit 132-pound weight class. Wrestling at 138 for the Vikings is Jordan Owens, sophomore, and his first year wrestling for the Vikings. He just clinched one of his first wins last match against North Miami. His opponent appears ready for the battle. Owens coming out with a Frosty. Takedown awarded to McConaughey. And they'll call that out of bounds. Owens setting the pace of this match. McConaughey looking for a tilt. Having smooth control over Owens. They're going to call that potentially dangerous. McConaughey not quite sure what he was doing. It's because his arm has to be straight in that position. Once you turn it to the side, there's a chance that you could break that arm, and they really just don't want that. Wouldn't be good for anybody here, viewers or wrestlers. Owens keeping movement on the ground, making it so McConaughey can't trap him. Owens finally gets turned. and rolls through. McConaughey will be awarded 3-point near fall. Right now, match score is 5-0. 10 seconds left to go in this first period. That'll be the end of the first period. Red chooses. Red will defer his choice. Owens will choose neutral. Conaqual working in that double leg. And there's the pin. Another 6 points for McConaughey. Wrestling at 145 for the Vikings is sophomore Chevy Teeter. Goes in for the quick single, works in the half, in great scoring position. Pulls in the half, needs to sink that elbow in all the way if he wants to get that successful. Looks as though he's got it cinched in. 1 minute left to go. There's the pin. And Teeter will get his first win of the day. Wrestling at 152 for the Vikings is Jonathan Humes. Sophomore. Neither wrestler gaining any advantage here. First 50 seconds of this match. Thank you. And that'll be the end of the first period. Remaining scoreless will be Green's decision. Or Red's decision. They will choose down. Humes covers. And McConaughey will get the quick escape. McConaughey looking for a throw, tying up high. Valley is the last match. Or this is the last match of Valley. Valley is the last team wrestling against McConaughey here before we go into the championship round. There he's going to call stalling on both. So far remaining scoreless besides those first 10 seconds of the second period. Warning on both again. 1 point awarded to each team for stalling. That'll be the end of the second period. Vikings will choose bottom. Currently match score is 2-1, McConaughey in the lead. And Humes will get the escape. Tied up 2-2. Whoever gets takedown here wins the match. Again, neither wrestler has scored. From the neutral position. A blow was thrown by McConaughey, starting to get aggressive. Thank you. Let's see what the ref's decision here. They're going to call that in Humes' favor. And that'll be the match. 32-48, final team score. As we get ready for the final round, the sixth round of this McConaughey invite. Again, I'm Jared Michael for RTC TV, and we'll see you in the sixth round. Welcome back to the sixth and final round of the McConaughey invite. Wrestling for seventh place against the Tippecanoe Valley Vikings is LaPelle. Vikings just coming off of a loss from McConaughey. They're going to start off with weight class 170 pounds. Wrestling for the Vikings is senior Tyler Manizak. Again, I'm Jared Michael for RTC TV, Channel 4. Both wrestlers signing in. As they prepare, Vikings will be the home team as green. This is the first time the Vikings have faced off on mat number 4 today. Discussion at the scoring table. Both wrestlers staying warm. Watch that struggling to find out what is wrong. Coach for the Vikings, Kyler Kerber, heading back to the sidelines. And it looks like they'll finally start wrestling now. Manizak going in for a quick shot. Trying to roll a fireman's carry. Manizak struggling. Right now, match score is 2-0.
Bring that arm back, make you pay for it. Let's go.
Seconds left to go in this first period. Seconds left to go. Manizak getting motioned by his coaches to get up. And gets a reversal. And that's the time. Going into the second period, it's all tied up, 2-2. LaPel versus Valley. We'll see how they do. Manizak is in the offensive position. Manizak in bad position. And LaPel will get the pin. 16 points awarded to LaPel in that first match. Wrestling at 182 pounds for the Vikings is Joseph Irons. It would appear that he's going to get a forfeit maybe. He'll get the forfeit, making him undefeated for today. Changing of weight classes means that he will not get any awards, but he's done a good job today. Vikings will have to forfeit 195 pounds. As well as 220 pounds. Neither wrestler appears to have a heavyweight. So when we go to the 106-pound weight class, that'll be sophomore Haley Hoover for the Vikings. Two points awarded to LaPel for that takedown. Hoover struggling. And rolled into a scoring position for LaPel. And that'll be the pin. At 113 pounds, Jacob Ehrman. Both wrestlers starting to be aggressive. LaPel getting a great behind position, dropping down Ehrman for the 2-point takedown. Ehrman rolling, getting stuck in bad position. LaPel dominating this match so far. Rolls in the half. Has Ehrman stacked up and releases it. Switches sides, gets a 2-point near fall. LaPel working slow and methodically as he's looking for that pin over Ehrman. Ehrman down. And that'll be another pin for LaPel. At 120 pounds for the Vikings is Devin Bandow, junior, and this is his first year wrestling for the Vikings. He hails originally from Texas.
He's been wrestling since elementary.
They're going to call that out of bounds. Could spell disaster being that close to metal bleachers. LaPel being just as aggressive as Bandow, something we oftentimes don't see, gets the takedown. Bandow looking for a long sit. LaPel keeping that butcher held in. Trying to roll Bandow over, looking for that cross face along with it. Bandow has struggled on his back so far this season. 30 seconds left to go. And that'll be the pin. Current team score, 30-12. LaPel leading. Vikings will have to forfeit 126 as well as 32 if LaPel has wrestlers. Viking, LaPel does not have a 26, however, they do have a 32, so that's one forfeit. For 138 for the Vikings, we have sophomore Jordan Owens wrestling. Jordan Owens being aggressive. So far, being his first year, doesn't have a whole lot of skill to go with that aggressiveness. LaPel staying safe. Trying to rack up that cradle. He has it locked in. And there's the pin. Wrestling at 145 for the Vikings is sophomore Chevy Teeter. Teeter trying to pin that hand to the ground. Oftentimes likes to go for that ankle pick after doing so. Gets a 2-point takedown. Chevy throws in that leg. He likes to leg ride. Oftentimes, though, he just wastes time in doing so. Would appear LaPel knows how to defend the leg. Thank you. They're going to call that out of bounds. Give LaPaul time to get his headgear back on again. Teeter will have the offensive position. Keeping that arm trapped. Teeter works forward. Trying to drive that up. Rolling across face. Throws that leg in. LaPaul appears ready for it. Teeter's hips are high. All LaPaul has to do is turn his body with that leg trapped. Ruff will call that. Teeter running wrists. Currently 5 seconds left to go in this first period. That's the end of the first. Vikings will defer their choice to LaPaul. LaPaul will choose down. Teeter in pad position.
Turn, spin.
Teeter currently working the tilt. LaPaul sensing his danger. Nine seconds left to go in the second period. And that's a pin for the Teeter. Wrestling at 152 pounds for the Vikings is Jonathan Humes. Team score currently 42-18. LaPaul in the lead.
Come on, Levi.
Humes, sophomore, first year. Thank you. 1:10 left to go. They're going to call that out of bounds. 2-point near fall. 3-point near fall is awarded to Humes.
Levi, keep your head up. Let's go.
Humes has him in the center of the mat. And there's a pin. Wrestling at 160 pounds for the Vikings is Isaac Randall. Randall trying to be the aggressive factor. LaPelle constantly breaking him down. They're going to call that out of bounds. Randall stays up. Isaac Randall will get the takedown. One-point escape awarded. And that'll be the end of the first period.